Allah, who is the most beneficent and the most merciful. Assalamu alaikum. John Keats as an escapist. All the poets of Keats's time were influenced by the ideas and ideals of French Revolution that brought to an end in 1789 the thousand-year rule of kings in France and established the nation as a republic. The ideas of the French Revolution had awakened the youthful passions of both Wordsworth and Coleridge. They had worked like yeast on Byron. They had brought forth new matter for Shelley. There was only one poet, Keats, of that age to whom they could not affect in any way. Keats longed to escape from the realities of life in a mood that seized him when he was contrasting the lot of man with that of nightingale. Sorrows and sufferings were inevitable in life, and he had fully realized that escape from the realities of life was neither possible nor desirable. Keats's lifelong creed was, a thing of beauty is a joy forever. Its loveliness increases, it will never pass into nothingness. Keats was so preoccupied with the beauty that he turned a deaf ear to the actualities of life around him. Keats always tried to attain serenity of mood in the midst of all the sufferings which he was undergoing in his own life and which he saw all around him. For Keats, the word of beauty was an escape from the dreary and painful effects of ordinary experience. His poetry indicates that melancholy and joy are transient by their nature. Just as Chaucer did not touch the contemporary historical and political events of his age, so Keats did. Keats was not a revolutionary idealist like Shelley, nor had he Shelley's reforming zeal. He was a pure poet. He had aesthetic taste in the masterpieces of the past, but no vital interest in the present, not in man as a whole, not in the political movement, not in the future of mankind, not in